We got Jordan Williams back here on the program, who's going to be fighting at Bellator 220. Jordan, how are you, man?
I'm doing good, James. How you doing?
I'm doing awesome, but not as good as you, though, man. You got some killer weather there. Where are you right now?
We're in Healdsburg, California, about, like, 50 miles up from Santa Rosa. Just lunch break,
Look at the dedication here, doing the interview on your lunch break. I appreciate that, man. You could be eating a sandwich right now, and instead you're talking to me, so I like that.
Hey, I mean, it's not like that's not going to happen right after. But,
of course, yeah. for sure. So, last time we saw you was on Contender Series, and you had a great performance in that fight. And then, obviously, after the fight, for those who don't know, I know you tested positive for marijuana metabolics. But that suspension wasn't that long, and you haven't fought since then, and that fight was back in June. What has been the reason for the layoff?
Working with my management and our team, trying to find the right fight and the right show that's, up to our par. They were talking about some possibilities before. I got offered for some smaller shows, but we just decided to, wait for someone like, Bellator to hit us up. And, thankfully they did.
Yeah. Was there any talks with the UFC after? Because you had a good performance. I mean, I know it says no contest on your record, but that really should be a TKO win. I thought that was a very, very great performance on your end.
Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate that, brother. On a five-day notice,
That's like, right. Against a tough guy in Tim Caron. Yeah.
It's like, I think it was a good performance in the shows of, being ready to go to the third round on any moment. And, since that, that medical marijuana that marijuana testing positive, 5 day notice, come on. But, there's a fight, talk about fighting to the UFC. I mean, that's kind of what my main thought was, even though that I was suspended. Maybe they want me to, do another fight and show that, get the correct testing results that so that it won't happen again, and maybe they'll trust me again for that next call.
Yeah.
So that's what's going on in my mind about, the whole UFC call.
Well, what I found odd about it was that they, I know you didn't get the contract that night, but Anthony Hernandez did, and he also got popped for something similar, but he got a fight, I guess, because they owed him because he won the contract. But, it just seems odd that they wouldn't have, sort of taken advantage of the fact that you had that good performance. But let's put that aside for a second. How was the overall experience going on Contender Series? I'm sure a lot of nerves being on that platform, but how was it?
Oh, it was great, man. That's the thing about having a five-day fight camp. Yeah, it's a short-notice fight. But at the same time, that's only 5 days of nerves that I had, And it really took away that. I feel like it's going to take away that UFC jitters. Like, I don't think I'm going to have that. And if I do make it to the big card someday soon, I don't think that, I'm going to have those jitters that most fighters have, because, I fought inside Octagon. I had Dana White right there viewing me, private performance. So, I feel like mentally that was a good experience for me, for sure. I mean, and the money doesn't hurt,
Yeah. No, for sure. That's great. So let's talk about your opponent here, Diego Herzog. What do you know about him? He's got, seven pro fights. How do you feel like you match up against him here?
Well, I feel like this, me and my coach, this is a perfect matchup. He is a jiu-jitsu, like, grappler type guy. I mean, he does have a standing knockout victory over Nick Pica. And I don't know, Nick Pica didn't really see himself that fight. But so he does have a left hand that he's landed, but I'm not really scared of that at all. And his strength. I'd say his strengths are more ground-based. Shoot, I train with some of the baddest people like Dave Terrell. So, he doesn't faze me at all and strike me with any fear into me in that aspect.
How about the weight cut? I know that's one thing where, if you've been off for a while. Is this a middleweight fight, by the way, or is this a catchweight?
No, it is. This is a middleweight fight.
Okay, good. Because I know sometimes Bellator does a lot of catchweight fights for whatever reason. So, yeah, just wanted to confirm that.
Right.
But how's the cut going?
Oh, the weight cut's going great. If you can even consider it being a weight cut. I walk around at 190 to 195. At my farthest point away from 186, I'm like 9 pounds away, which is really comforting, to me.
Okay. And you talked a little bit about some of your training partners. Who are some of the other fighters you get to work with at your gym?
There's a guy, Colin Hart. He was on the Tough. He was on Tough before. He had a fight in the UFC. There's also this guy, Adam Wamsley, Gabriel Pacheco, and Joaquin Lopez. All three of those guys are studs. Joaquin, he's on a 5-streak win streak. All of them KO. Or I think he might have one decision, but I think he's either all KOs or 4 knockouts and 1 decision. So he is on a terror right now. His last fight was for LFA, Legacy. And, you know, he knocked that guy out in the first or second round. So that was, you know, I have really solid training partners that I really put the trust of my training camp in.
And on that same note, who's going to be in your corner for this fight?
So 2 for sure is Geraldo. He's my boxing coach. He's also my barber. So, you know, that's 2 birds, 1 stone right there. And Dave Terrell. So those two, they have locked positions in my corner. And the third guy is kind of like someone who can be there, usually someone who I train with and like one of the fighters. So there's 2 things that happen with that. Like they get the, you know, help me out with my stuff. I get training right then and there. It's someone that can miss work or leave the gym and be there when I'm like, you know, doing that final weight cut and final prep. And also it's you know, a fighter who maybe even if they haven't been to this level before, that, you know, they can, you know, get their eyes and visualize themselves being there and kind of like help them out and like picture themselves being there as well.
Are we going to see another finish in this fight? That seems to be the theme in your last couple fights.
Well, I mean, out of even the fights I've lost, which I've had 10 of them, there's only been one that went the distance. It was my second pro fight, so I mean, shoot, I try to finish it every time, and I will endanger myself sometimes to get that finish. Sometimes I've been finished, so I am I'm putting my money down on him, you know. Mm-hmm. But I'm thinking knockout, you know. That's what I want. I'm not too flashy. I've been working my hands, you know. It's just gonna be nice technical work, and We're going to see what he has to say about, you know, being clean and crisp, to see who can come out on top.
And I guess the plan after this is to continue to try and get big fights, and even better, you know, maybe see if you can get a multi-fight contract from Bellator. Because we've seen that, you know, Austin Vanderford's another guy that the UFC, you know, he won on the show, and then they didn't take advantage of it, and now he's in Bellator. So maybe you could follow in the same footsteps.
Yeah, the highest two platforms in the game, and anyone who has something on the table to offer me my time, I'm going to take it. And I have no stipulation against either one of the two, even though, like, you know, people say, oh, Bellator, that's not UFC. Or they say, oh, how do you feel about UFC? Do you have a grudge against them not taking you? It's like, nope, I understand it's all business. And, you know, whoever is going to pay me the most for mine is who's going to basically have me.
And last question before I let you go, obviously you're at work right now. Does that taper off a little bit closer to fight time, or do you still work right up until the fight?
Oh, no, I requested a week off before the fight. You know, the last couple of fights before then, or before this one, the contender was the last day, as soon as I got the call, like that day, I told my boss, like, hey, I gotta take off. And he was really cool about it. And he obviously understood. The Bellator fight, I had basically almost through the whole training camp, I had off of work, and that was really nice. So this time, you know, I don't get that luxury, you know, but usually I'm planning on taking 1 week. I told them, just be sure, just be careful, maybe plan for 2 weeks, like have a week before the fight and then a week after, based on if I get any injuries and I can't really perform in the workplace for a week after. So that's our game plan.
Well, we're looking forward to your return, Jordan. It's great to see you on another big platform here for Bellator. It is Bellator 220 coming up here very soon. Just remind people where they can find you on social media, and if you have any sponsors or shout-outs, the floor is yours, man.
Oh, my man. Thanks, James. So social media, you know, Jordan Williams, that's Facebook. I have a lovely picture recommended by Bellator to be as my profile and cover. So, you know, you'll you'll see those details. Instagram, Boomayay MMA. It's BOMAYEMMA, like Ali Boomayay. Twitter, JDub_NCFA. Those are my social media outlets. The sponsors, I really want to give a shout-out. Thanks to is number one, Capstone. Always been a huge sponsor and friend. That was actually one of my old working or companies I used to work for, and he just gave me a nice sponsorship. So shout-out to you, Nate Desharm, and Capstone. I have Sykes Asphalt, really good friend of mine. My brother Jake, he's all these guys, they have loyal prices. They're like the top roofing and asphalting companies in Santa Rosa. Also, I have Matrix Nutrition. That's a good one. That's a new one that I've taken on before this fight that I didn't have with the other one. So we're going to see. You're going to see how much better I'm going to be able to perform and train with Matrix Nutrition in my corner. I really like, they have this memory supplement that, you know, I think that all fighters, you know, having suffering, you know, head trauma should really soak up on that nutrient that they have, that nutrient supply. There's also, let's see, there's Avenue Tattoo, my man Alejandro Cruz from Avenue Tattoo. He's been doing some nice sleeve work that, you know, obviously you're going to see on camera. So those are some main ones right now. I just don't want to take up too much time with me trying to bring him up. The other ones, but oh, Mo Documentary, she's been really helping me making my sponsorship posters and really helping me find, you know, the extra funds that are going to help with this training camp.